Hello, beautiful people. My name is Ferdy, and in this video, I will show you step by step how you can create an amazing website using WordPress. Let me show you in the next couple of minutes what we are going to cover in this tutorial. This is the website we are going to make with a few nice animations, a beautiful hero, the first thing people will see when they enter your website, and a beautiful menu. When we scroll down a bit, you see that the logo changes and that the background of the menu changes and it will be sticky. We will make use of the Bloxy theme, an amazing free theme that will enable you to do all these things. We also have a search area, so if I search for how to, it will show a few suggestions, and when you click over there, you directly go to that page or that blog post. Let's go back to the homepage. Again, I will show you how to do those animations, and I will not just say in this video, okay, click here, do this, do that, but I'll also talk about why we do what we do. Why do I show this title? Why do I show this text? Why do I show two options instead of one or instead of none? So we'll not just design a website, but also talk about why we do what we do, because the ultimate goal is to convert a visitor into a customer. Then we scroll down. I will show you how to create galleries, how to show videos. I will show you how to import pre-made areas and change the look of view so you can make your website really quick. And I will also show you how to import pre-made pages so you can just change the look and feel and save a lot of time. We'll talk about blog posts, about portfolio items, about the footer, and I click over here and I go to the top of my website. If I want to change something, I log into my website and I click on edit with Elementor. That is the free page builder we will use in this tutorial. And if I want to change the text, I can change branding to modeling. And if I want to make it a little bit bigger, I go to the style of the heading, click on typography, and I increase it. Maybe I want to make it thinner. Okay, I can do that, or I can make it really bold. And then I can decrease this area again. That's how easy it is. Maybe I want to change the uppercase to default. That's how you can do that. Align it. Awesome. Maybe I want to change the color of this button. I can do that over here. I click on the button. I go to the style. I click on the color and I change it. Maybe it's a little bit overwhelming, but I will show you step by step how you can do those things. If I don't like it, I say Command or Control Z and I go back to the default option. I want to make this a little bit bigger. So I click over here. I go to the style and I want to increase the size of the icon. And I want to give it a different color. But then I need to do the same over here. So instead of doing it again, I say right mouse click, copy, paste the style, paste the style. So you see the icons remain the same, but the color and the size change. And that's what you can do with the Elementor page builder. Do you want to change this image? Click over here, go to the style, click on the image and select another one. Who we are, what we do. You can change the text, you can change the colors, you can change the size. And it's also easy, and I will show you step by step how you can do that. So that's what you can do with the Elementor page builder. And right now I'm only changing things, but if you scroll down, you can create a new area. Let's say with three columns. And then I click over here and I have a lot of elements I can drag over here. So I can drag an image over here. I go back, text editor button, and much more elements. So after watching this video, you will know how to build websites with Elementor. So let's continue. We can go to the about page. I'll show you how to import this page and adjust the information over here. I'll show you how to create this from scratch. The services page. I'll show you how to import this so you can save a lot of time and change the information. And then we will talk about portfolio. If you want to, you can showcase the things you have done for your business so you can convince people that they need to do business with you. So I have a portfolio over here and you can filter it by your category. If people want to take a look, they can click over here and see the thing you have made. I created a template for this so every portfolio item looks the same. So if I would go to a different one, it looks like this. Same style and again, related projects. Then we go to the blog. Why do we have a blog on our website? Well, you can create blog posts and that information will be fetched by Google. And then through the organic results of Google, you can get visitors to your website that can become your client. That's actually the way how you found this video. You searched on something, you found this video, and now you're watching it. So you provide free value. And that's why you create blog posts, helping other people to learn something new, to explain something, to entertain them. And that's what I will show you in the tutorial, how you can do that. So for instance, I click over here. We see the blog post over here with the Bloxy theme. I decided that I wanted to be displayed like this, the title, some information about myself, an excerpt, and then our blog post with images, styling. I'll show you how to do that. And then through the Bloxy theme, you have all those extra options, which is amazing. Over here, we have a sidebar, and there you have widgets that can display more information. Maybe you can have an advertisement over here. You can make money with your website. All those things you can do. Then there's the contact page, so people can reach out to you. I will show you how to create a contact form. And this is something great about Elementor. Maybe you're going to create websites for clients and your client says, I like it, but I don't like the colors. I want to change them. So what you can do now, you can go to the homepage, for instance, edit the page with Elementor. And then at Elementor, you can change the global colors. So here it says global colors. Look at this. If I change this color, let's make it purple, for instance, dark purple. And then this one becomes, I don't know, just swipe, maybe a little bit light blue or light purple. Look at this. The whole style of our website is changed. All the links, all the backgrounds, those colors over here, and all with a few clicks. So let me show you again. If I make this orange, and the second color, blue, you change the look of view of your website with just a few clicks, and you have done it through the whole website, and that will save you a lot of time. Again, Command-Z to bring it back. And of course, we will make your website responsive for every device, for a desktop, for tablets, and for smartphones. So this and so much more is what I will show you in this tutorial. In the description of the video, I've timestamps. So if you want to go to a certain part of this video, you can go to the description and click on the timestamp so you can go directly to that part of the video. And if I go too fast for you, you can click over here and slow down the speed of the tutorial. I've been making tutorials now for over 5 years and people seem to love my videos. I do my best to get better and better so I can reach more people with my tutorials. If you have any question or feedback, feel free to leave a comment below the video. So I hope you like what you're seeing so far. If that's the case, please like this video and feel free to subscribe for more upcoming WordPress related tutorials. And sometimes I talk about something else, Facebook, affiliate marketing, but mainly WordPress. And then I would like to say, let's get started. What are the four things we are going to do in this tutorial? If you're starting from scratch, I can show you how to get a domain name and web hosting, and I can give you 60% off discount. After that, we will install WordPress, and then we will get the Bloxy theme and the Elementor page builder. When we have done that, we will create an amazing website. And if you have a domain name and web hosting already and you have installed WordPress, then you can go to step 3 and I will show you the timestamp so you can go immediately to that point in the video. So the first two things we need in order to create a website are a domain name and web hosting. If you have this already, that's great. Then you can skip this part. If you don't have it, then you can go to webhostingfk.com. Hit enter. And you will be redirected to NameHero. NameHero is, in my opinion, the best web hosting provider there is. Why? Let me give you a few reasons. There are more, but one. Your website will load fast, even if you go for the cheapest package. Why? Because NameHero has invested in Lightspeed, which is way faster than Apache, which is used with a lot of different web hosting companies. Here you see an overview what the difference is when you use WordPress. The second one, the prices are really competitive. You get premium web hosting for an affordable rate, which is amazing. And the third one, really important, the support. You can call them 24/7. You can open a live chat 24/7 and you can leave a ticket and they will get back to you. So three ways to get support. And that's what I love about NameHero. Now, one of the reasons you get such affordable prices here at NameHero is because I get an exclusive discount for you up to 66% instead of the regular 50% that you get at NameHero. And if you want to see what the plans are, click over here on this button or scroll down. And there are four packages: the Starter Cloud, the Plus Cloud, Turbo Cloud, and the Business Cloud. So what are the differences between those packages? With the Starter Cloud, you can start with one domain name. So if you're really on a budget, this is where you can start. You have one website, 1 gigabyte of RAM. It's just like your computer. The more RAM you have, the faster your computer will remain. Also, if you're doing a lot of things at the same time. So if you get a lot of visitors at the same time, then you can upgrade. But I'm talking about hundreds of visitors per day. You have unlimited SSD storage. What does it mean? You can have 250,000 files on your website, which is more than enough. You have free SSL. That means that you can make your website secure. With other web hosting companies, it can cost money. Here it is free, even with the starter cloud plan, and free website migration. So if you have a website already and you want to transfer it to NameHero, you can do that for free. Then we have the Plus Cloud. What is the big difference? Well, you have more gigabyte of RAM, so more people can go to your website at the same time. And you can have up to 7 websites. And the great thing is, when you get this package, you can have 7 different domain names and all store them under one web hosting package. You get 60% discount. You pay $5.18 per month, and then you can have 7 websites. So that is less than $1 per website per month. So my opinion, if you're starting, get this package. And if you're really like, okay, money doesn't matter, I just want to go with the best of the best of the best, then I suggest you go for the Turbo Cloud. You can have unlimited websites, so you can even become a web design agency, start to make websites for clients and host them all on your website and charge them $20 per month for web hosting, depending on what you want to offer. And the great thing about this package is that your websites become even faster using NVMe storage, which is faster than SSD. So your website will go so fast. And the great thing is those websites are already fast. This one becomes even faster. You have the Speed Boost plugin and you will have a free domain, which is quite nice. And then if you're like, you know, I have too much money, I just want to get the best of the best of the best, then you can go for the Business Cloud. And then I'm talking like if you have 50 websites hosting on NameHero, then I would go for the Business Cloud. The great thing is you can always upgrade later. So you can start with the Plus Cloud, for instance, and then later go to the Turbo Cloud. Send them an email. They will fix it for you. What I want to do now, I want to start with a new website. So I want to start with the Plus Cloud. So the whole year I can decide if I want to create a second website or a third one, and I don't pay anything extra except for the domain name. So in order to purchase it, I scroll down and I go to order now. And then we need to register a new domain name. Well, a domain name can be registered only once. So if I say I want to have facebook.com and I click on search, Facebook is unavailable. So you need to have a unique domain name, and I would like to go with FertiWP, Ferti WordPress. Then you can have .com. You can have a lot of different extensions. If you want to go international, I would go for .com. And you can go for your own country. So for instance, my country is the Netherlands. I can have this one or the UK. Well, as you see, there are a lot of extensions over here. So there are so many, but I would go internationally for .com and or locally for your own country extension. And talking about names, if you want to start a new business, use that business name. If it's already taken, you can become creative with your name. I highly suggest you always have your own first and last name as .com. You never know what you want to do in your life. And if you have it, you have it. So I go for FertiWP.com. I click on search and it is available and it's for free if I go for 2 or 3 years at once. So I click on continue. I'll explain that to you. Over here, we can choose our billing cycle. And the great thing is the amazing discount of 60% will be applicable on the first invoice. So if you go for 1 year, you get 1 year of discount, 2 years of discount, or 3 years of discount. And the longer you go, the more extra discount you get, as you see, say 30% or 6%. So the longer you go, the cheaper it becomes. I want to go with 1 year. And then there are a few extra things we can take over here. Would you like to add dedicated IP address? Well, I don't need all these things. Auto encrypt is free. We don't need this one. So I click on continue. And then really important, what we need is ID protection. It only costs less than $3 per year. And this will make sure that when you sign up, spammers that will see all the new websites in the world will not spam you with a lot of things like, hey, let me create a logo or do SEO or create a website for you, or they will call you. You don't want that. So if you use ID protection, they cannot see all your details. So click on continue. And the great thing is, this is crazy. The total amount we have to pay is less than $100. With other web hosting companies, really good ones also, you pay around $150, sometimes more, and here below $100. I really like it. We save a lot of money. And what we have the Web Hosting Plus Cloud, so we can have 7 websites, and we have our domain registration. And since I go for 1 year, I need to pay around $16 for it. But this is great. This is for 12 months of web hosting and a domain name. You can start your business for just $7 per month. So what I can do now, I can create a new account. So I will leave my details over here. That's not my name. This is my name, my last name, my email address, my phone number, and then my company name. I have a company with my wife and it's called Ferdinand Anna Media. I'm from this address. So I need to fill in your details over here. How did you find us? Well, through YouTube, because I'm showing you. And then you have a support pin. If you want to call them or have a chat session with them, they ask for a pin so you can leave it here and then they know you're really you. Now we need to create a password, of course, make it really secure, or you can generate one. And then you need to confirm your password. Then I scroll down and you can pay with credit card, PayPal, Coinbase, or credit card with Stripe. Well, I want to go with credit card, so I can leave my details over here. I scroll down. Do I want to receive emails for special savings? Well, there's a great thing. Well, every year there's Black Friday and Cyber Monday, and then they gave huge discounts for extending the service. So you can get some money on your Name Hero account, and then Name Hero adds extra money for you. So in that way, you have discount for the next invoice. And if you have written agreed to the terms of service, you can check this. Keep in mind that when you got here through webhostingfk.com, you don't pay more, but you get extra discount and I get a commission. So I see that as a win-win situation. Name Hero will check all your details and see if there's no fraud. Well, if it's you that's filling in the information, then it should be fine. So I can go to the checkout and it says order confirmation, order is placed. If you have any questions about your order, please open a support ticket from your client area and quote your order number. I want to go to the client area. So I want to congratulate you. You have your own domain name and web hosting. That is amazing. And the great thing with Name Hero, your website is live immediately. The only thing is if you go to ferdywp.com, it looks a little bit weird. So we need to install WordPress. But the great thing is it's not with all web hosting companies that your website is live immediately. If you want to install WordPress, you click over here on My Cloud, and then you click over here on Web Hosting Plus Cloud. Here we can log into the cPanel. And now we can install WordPress. We need to scroll down, or we search over here for WordPress. And there it is, WordPress Manager by Softaculous. Click on it. And then I click on install. So we see the newest version of WordPress. Here we can choose our domain name. If you have more domain names, you can select one. And then here I want to select HTTPS. So our website will be secure from moment one. We need to remove WP, otherwise your website will be installed on your domainname.com/WP. No, you want it to be in the root directory. So people go to ferdywp.com and then they go to my website. Here you can give your website a name and a site description. And you really need to do this now, otherwise, yeah, you can do this only once. No, just kidding. You can do this in the website. I will leave it for now and we will do it later in the website. Here we can choose a username. Ferdy Corp, for instance, and a beautiful password. Oh, hide. You can let it be created or create your own. Let's see if I can go stronger than 65. In real life, I'm not that strong, so I'd rather be strong on the internet with my password so I can say to people that I'm strong. Man, I'm so strong. And then your admin email, you need to have access to this email address. And then you can select your site language. You can install two plugins, the classic editor and the limit login attempts, and I don't need those. I click over here and I close it because it looks too complicated. This is all fine. You can trust them. This is all fine. And we don't need to install a theme. We will do that from within WordPress. And if you want to, you can send the email installation details to an email address, but I leave it as it is. I click on install. And there it is. Congratulations, the software was installed successfully. So if I would go to this link, and ladies and gentlemen, this is your website. You have a different domain, but you have this area over here. It does not look good, but it means you are live at this moment. 10 minutes ago, we bought web hosting and the domain name, and now we are live. That's amazing. So this is the front end of the website. Everybody that will see your domain or go there, hit enter, they will see your website. But we want to change the website. We want to configure things. And in order to do that, we need to go to the back end of the website. The website has a front end. That's what you will see, what the visitors will see. And there is a front end. And you can click over here and then you'll see the back end. And right now you see it's not secure. And it can be that you also see that over here, That's the case. Sometimes it is secure, sometimes not, but in the end, everything will be secure. So in order to do that, you need to go to the backend. And before we do that, I want to talk about the backend a bit more. This is the place for the users, for you, to configure your website, to create new pages, upload images, PDFs if you want to, install plugins if you want to sell products on the internet or have a Facebook like box or whatever. All that can be done through the backend. And then there's the front end, that is what people see. So really important, the front end and the back end. And if I click over here, I go to the front end. And now, here you don't see that, but now you see a bar over here. That means that you're logged in. And when you're logged in, you can scroll down and you'll still see this bar. And you can add a new post, add a new page, add some media, add a new user. You can update things, you can customize the theme. We'll talk about that. And you can go back to the back end. So this we don't need anymore. So right now we have the back end, and if we click over here, we go to the front end. So let's talk about the back end. I click over here, and this is our dashboard, an overview with a lot of information. And then here at the left, we can have updates. And if I click over here, I scroll down, I see there are two themes that need an update. So I can select them, update those. So every time there is an update for a plugin or a theme or whatever, you can update it over here and you'll see it in the top bar. Then there's post. We can add new blog posts. We can add PDFs, videos, media, whatever, Word documents, and we can check them or we can add new ones. Well, then there are pages like the homepage, the about page. We can create those. If you have blog posts and people comment on it, you can see that over here. You can approve them or put them into the spam. Then there's the appearance. You can change the look and feel of your website using themes. We're going to talk about that. Then there are plugins, extra functionalities for your websites. You can make your website a web shop. Let's take a look. If I click on add new, you can add the classic editor, which is the old editor of WordPress. You can have anti-spam, make your website more secure. You can have a forum. You can have a social media website. All those things can be added to your website. Then there are users. You can add more users that can change the whole website, or you can add a user that only can add blog posts. So you can hire someone that will write blog posts for your website. Then you can export your website, import your website. And then there are the settings. We'll take a look at that in a second. You know what? Let's do it right now. Let's go to general in order to make our website secure. Add an S over here. That's everything you need to do. Over here and over here. Then you save it and then you need to log in again. But now it is secure. If I go to the front end, it is also secure. So that's great. What I want to do now, I want to start with a clean WordPress installation. So if I take a look over here, it's kind of overwhelming. So what I want to do, I want to remove everything we don't need and I want to start from scratch. So over here, I see I have one blog post. So if I click over here, I can bring it to the trash. Then I go to the trash over here and I can empty the trash. The same thing we can do at pages. I click over here, then I see all the pages. I click over here, so I select them all, bulk actions, move to the trash, apply. Then I go to the trash and I empty the trash. Okay, then we go to plugins. Two plugins, they're both deactivated. So if they're activated, you can select them both. Say bulk actions, deactivate them first. You need to deactivate them first before you can remove them, but they're both deactivated. So I click on delete. I don't need those two. Yes. Awesome. Then I want to go to the settings, general. Here we can give a title to our website. And that's really important. So don't say welcome to this website, because this is a really important tag. What you write over here will be the keyword or the key phrase of your website. So you can say, my name is Ferdy Korpershoek and I make websites. But when people want to search for a web designer, they don't search for Ferdy Korpershoek because they don't know me. They search for web design. So the keyword that you want to be found on needs to be first. So what I would do is put the name of my company in the back and the keyword in the front. So I want to offer three services. First, branding. I help new companies to create a branding for the website, like the look and feel of their website, a logo, all that stuff. Then I use a pipe and I say web design. Shift backslash is a pipe. And then I say digital marketing. So what I do as a service, I help people that have a business and a good idea to do the branding. So they have a really good style for their website, for their brochures. Sorry, that's hard to pronounce for a Dutch person. Web design, I do the web design for them. And I say web design like this. And then we do the digital marketing. So when they have their website, their branding, all that stuff, and they have a good message to show to the world, I will do Facebook advertisement for them, Google advertisement, maybe YouTube advertisement. So those three services I offer. And then there's a tagline and it says, in a few words, explain what this site is all about. And then I can say, we bring your ideas to life. That can be my slogan. Why did I wrote life with a V? I don't want to record this whole area again. I know it's with an F. I don't know what was happening to me, but sorry. Let's continue with the video. And before I continue, at the site title, what I do after that, or I say the name of the place if I work locally, so I can say Rotterdam or Amsterdam or New York, or I say my company name, which is Ferdy Corp Media. So it's up to you. I leave it at this. Branding, web design, digital marketing. We bring your ideas to life. Then we can scroll down. We can change the site language over here. The time zone meets plus one. We can change the date format, the time format. So if you want to have capital AM, you can do that. So I use this one. The week starts for me on Monday. So I save the changes. That's awesome. Then I go to the permalinks. We're still cleaning up our website, making it look better. And we change this day and name to post name. Why? Right now, if I have a blog post, we went to Australia, it'll say your domain / the year, the month, the day, and then we went to Australia. And I'd rather have the post name, so it will say my domain name / we went to Australia. So that's better. And Google also likes it, and this is the worst. That when you go to a blog post, it will say this code. This is not good for the search results. One of the most important things to be found on the internet is your domain name and your URL. So post name. So if I search for how to make a forum, and I scroll, it says HostGator. It says create forum website. So it has three keywords in the URL. So you see, it's important to have a good post name over here. Save the changes. So whatever the title is in your blog post or in your page, that will be shown over here instead of this stupid code or the date, which is not necessary. Okay, let's go to the dashboard. I want to clean it up a little bit. I can collapse everything. Or even better, I can click over here on the screen options and remove everything. This looks so much better in my opinion. And then I see over here, this area, Ferdy Corp. I want to add my user. I can do that over here, or I go to users profile. And then I can change the look and feel of my backend. So if you see something you like, you can use that. I like the default one. And then I scroll down. I want to enter my first name. I want to enter my last name. I can have a nickname. I can change it. And here the display name publicity. Right now it says Ferdy Corp. So if I have a blog post, it will say this is written by Ferdy Corp. Oh, I rather have Ferdy Corpus Hook, my full name. And now it says howdy Ferdy Corpus Hook. That is better. And I want to see an image over here. So you need to have a Gravatar account. So right now I have ferdycorp@gmail.com. And then I have a profile picture over here. So right mouse click. Open a new tab. Over here, I can sign in for free and I can upload an image, and that image will be linked with the email address you use over here when you sign in. And if you use the same email address within your WordPress website, then that image will appear. So I have an account over here. It's linked to info@ferdycorpushook, as you see. So if I grab this, copy, and I paste it here in my contact info email, that means that my Gravatar account will be linked to this WordPress website. So if I update it, and I need to confirm it, now you see this image, which is linked to this email account. So you can sign up really easily for Gravatar, and then your profile picture will be seen over here. Then there's a text you can have about yourself. So If you write blog posts and there's an area with about the author, this text will appear. I make websites for a living and I love to help people to achieve more in life. Something like that. You can set a new password and you can update your profile. So if I go over here to the backend, it looks clean, no unnecessary stuff. And if I take a look at the front end, it still looks bad. So what I want to do, I want to talk about themes. Right now I see the title of my website and I see the subtitle. And then there's nothing here because we don't have blog posts yet. But take a look at this information, the title, the subtitle, and then nothing here. I can change the theme. That means I can change the look and feel. The theme decides how your website will look, and every theme has their own customization options. So if I click here on customize, I can customize this theme. And if I go back and I go to the back end, I can go to themes. And now if I choose a different theme, 2020, for instance, and I go to the website, that means I have the same information, the title, the subtitle, but the look and feel is different. And that is what a theme does. And I want to work with the best free theme there is. So if you want to download the best free theme for your WordPress website, then let's go to ferdycorp.com/blogc, hit enter. You'll be redirected to the blogc website. And there is a special offer for the pro version, but I want to download the free version. So I click on download. We can download it over here. There it goes. And look how it goes with this theme. It's growing because it's such an amazing theme. I can close this, then I can go to my website, to the backend, or I go hover over here and I go to themes. Then I click on add new. I can search on this list, or I can upload the theme. Or maybe you can also find it here, blogc. And there it is. So you don't even have to leave WordPress in order to get this theme. So I can also click here, click on install. Maybe I went a little bit too fast. I click on activate first. So in order to find the theme, you go to appearance, themes, click on add new. Then there's an overview with a lot of different themes. You can find the popular ones. And there are a lot of good ones, but I think after doing a lot of research, this is the best one. So there you can search for it, or you can upload it yourself. Well, I installed the blogc companion because that makes blogc even better. I install it now. Over here, I want to skip this. Awesome. What we can do if we want to, we can click on starter sites and we can import a complete website that is already made. Now, if you hover over it, you can use different page builders. So I like Elementor, we're going to use Elementor, but you can import pre-made templates from scratch. So you can save yourself a lot of time. I will not do that in this tutorial, where I'm going to show you how you can create your own website. After that, we will work with pre-made templates and all that stuff, but I want to show you as much as possible to help you to create an amazing website. Okay, so this is the theme. The theme decides how the header should look and the footer should look. So right now we activated this theme. If I take a look now at the front end, it looks better. It still looks, does not look good, but it looks better already. We have the area for the logo. We can have a menu over here. Here we can have the content of our website, and here we can have the footer. So what is a theme? A theme helps you to create a beautiful header and a beautiful footer. And it helps you to show the blog posts in a really good way, the blog post archive, where I see an overview of all the blog posts. But in order to create content, we need a page builder. There's Gutenberg that comes with WordPress. There's the Divi page builder, which costs money. And there's also Elementor. And Elementor is by far the best free page builder in the world. So if you want to find it, you can go to ferdycorp.com/Elementor, hit enter. And then you can click on get started. Do you have a WordPress website? Yes. And if you don't want to do all this stuff, you can click over here and you can download Elementor. And there it goes. So we can go to our website. So we installed the theme already, but a page builder is a plugin. So we can go to plugins, add new, upload a plugin. I drag it over here. But again, we can also search over here for Elementor. And there you find it, Elementor Website Builder. Install now. So I don't need this. And then I click on activate. So now I can close this. Elementor will be activated. You can watch all these videos, but I will also show you step by step how you can work with Elementor. And if you want to know from scratch everything, I will cover a lot in this tutorial, but I will also show you different ways to work with Elementor. If you really want to get everything out of Elementor, there's a tutorial over here. Ferdy, and then search for Elementor. Elementor tutorial for beginners 2020. Well, it's 2 months old, so I think it's still for 2021. 99% likes. And here I have 1.5 hours where I show you everything about Elementor. This is my son, my beautiful son. I love him. He's amazing. And I hope there will be more children in the future. So since we installed Elementor, there's a new area in our dashboard with updates and stuff. If you want to have that, you can have it. But I want to remove it. So I keep it clean because I like things to be clean. I want to keep everything organized. So if I would go to the website, to the front end, I want to edit the homepage, but I don't have a page. So I cannot edit this page because there is no page. So what we need to do now, we need to create pages. How can we do that? The best way is to go to the customizer. And the great thing about the Bloxy theme is that this area really looks beautiful. With other themes, it looks different. As I showed you in this example, you see it looks different. This was the 2021 theme. This is the Bloxy theme. And the first thing I want to do, I want to make it dark over here. Wow, I like that. I like it, man. This is the first theme I came across that has a dark interface at the customizer. So what I want to do, I want to scroll down until I see menus. So here at the core, I see menus. Then I can create a new menu and I call this one main menu. This is just for reference. You will be the only one that will see this. So you can call this whatever you want. I just say main menu and I want to show this in the header menu one. Okay. Then I click on next and now I can add items to this menu by clicking on add items. And this looks a little bit weird in the dark interface. I have to say, I need to go over here and I type in home. I need to create a homepage. When I typed home, I click on add and it will be added to our menu. Then the second one, what do you want to show on your website? Well, it depends. I would like to say something about myself. So I can say about me or about us. I say about, this is the second page. So I have the homepage and the about page. And what you can do, you can go to different pages, maybe from competitors, not to steal everything, but you can get inspiration from other websites to see how they do it. So for instance, if I am a web design company in LA, I can also search for web design company in Sydney. And I click over here. Wow, that's really nice. You cannot even enter that website. Let me go to a organic results. Okay, this one. So what you see over here, they sell websites, they have the homepage, they have the portfolio. Okay, so I can think I need to have a portfolio. The services, FAQs, testimonials about, okay, now I'm inspired. So I say services, I edit, there it is. If you want to, you can have a portfolio where you can showcase what you can do for your clients. We can have a blog page where we show blog posts. We can have a contact page or get in touch, whatever you prefer. And I want to have a sub menu over here. I have services and I have three services. The first one is branding. The second one is web design. And the third one is digital marketing. Okay, that's it. So let me click outside of this area. If I say command minus, I see my menu over here. Wow. What I've learned from other websites like apple.com. No, apple.com. If I go to the iPhone page, I want to go back to the home page. I see no home over here, but I can see the logo. If I click on it, I go back to the home page. So that's what I also want to do. I don't want to have the home area over here. So I click over here at the left, I scroll down and I click on remove. Now I click on publish. Publish is the other word for saving the customization configuration. And now we see about, services, portfolio, blog, and more, because it does not fit right now. But what I want to do, I want to have a submenu over here, just like this. So how can I do that? I want to add those three services below services. I drag it a little bit to the right and then I release it. Web design below it, digital marketing below it. And what happens now? I have services and when I hover over it, I see branding, web design, digital marketing. That's what I want. I publish it. Then I go back and I go back. And what I want to do now, right now it says ready to publish your first post. So right now the homepage is showing our latest posts, but I don't want that. So I scroll down to the homepage settings and then I don't want to display my latest post over here, but a static page, which is the homepage we just created. And then the post page can be the blog page. Awesome. I publish it. Then I close this. So what will happen? We have the homepage over here. So when we go to our website, let's say command minus to make it a full 100% resolution. And if I go to the about page, you see /about instead of /?, P123 ID, stupid things. No, it looks beautiful. Why? Because we decided that way when we went to the perma links in the settings. So far so good. What I want to do, I want to configure the theme settings so I can add a logo, I can change the menu, I can have a top menu, I can have a bottom menu, I can have a scrolling menu that sticks with us, I can have a transparent menu with a different logo. I want to do all those things. Where can I do that? In the customizer. But before I do that, I want to go to the home page. And since I have a page over here, I can click on edit page. Then I want to edit it with Elementor. And what I want to do, I want to import a pre-made template so we can see what all those changes will do with our website. So I click on the folder. Don't look at this yet. I will show you a lot about Elementor, but right now click on the folder. And then I want to import a pre-made page. So let's do the first one over here, insert. Then I need to connect to the template library. Nothing bad they will do with your email address. You just need to connect. I have a connection already because I'm a member of Elementor. So sign up, really easy. They will do nothing worse. They will do nothing bad with your email, but it's just the way how they do things. And now I've imported this area. Then I need to do two things. Click over here and hide the title, this area. Scroll down, page layout, make it full width. Like that. And then I want to remove this upper area. How can I do that? I go over here to the navigator and this header, right mouse click, delete. That's it. Update. Then I say command E or control E on the PC and I search for home. And I want to go to the home page over here. Okay. So right now we have this page pre-made with Elementor. So it shows you a little bit what you can do with Elementor. What we want to do, we want to configure this area and this area below. So how can we do that? We click on the customizer. And because this area makes our website smaller, I see this website right now as on a tablet. So if I say command minus one time, then I can see the website as it is shown on a desktop. So let's configure this. So the first thing I want to add is a logo. In order to do that, I can click over here. Then I go directly to that part. That's really nice in this theme. You just click over here or on the menu and you can edit it. So right now I can add a logo. And if you want to go there from scratch, you can go to header. Then click on the logo. You can select the logo. If you don't have a logo or you want to learn how to make one, I'm not a designer, but I can show you how to create an easy logo. You can go to YouTube and search for 30 logo. I have 3 tutorials. How to create one within 5 minutes. How to create one with Photoshop and how to create one with a transparent background. And that's really important. So I would watch this one if I were you. And I made my logo through this tutorial. If you have Photoshop, you can do that. And if you really want to take it to the next level, you can hire a designer to do it for you. But I did it myself and I had this logo. So I click on select logo, select files. And then I have here my logo. 500 pixels in the width and 60 in the height. I open it and I want to select it. There it goes. It's way too big. So how can I make it smaller? Well, over here, I can do that. I think 30 is okay. You know what? 26. I don't want to show the site title below it, so I remove that. And then it looks better already. So let's go back. Now I have my logo. So a few things I want to do. I want to go to general layout. I want to change the width to 1140. And if you want to, you can learn from other websites, like how wide is their website, apple.com. If I say Shift Command 4 on my Mac, I can make a selection and see how wide it is, less than 1,000 pixels. And if I go to New York Times, is around 1,220. Well, I want to go for 1140. That's what I like. Then I go back. I want to focus on creating this header area, which has a lot of options. If you want to know everything about this theme, how you can configure it, you can go to YouTube and search for Ferdy Block C. And to appear, it's a week old. It's 1.5 hour long. Well, I don't want to focus 1.5 hour on this theme. I just want to focus on this header area. That's what we can do now. So I go back from general. Then I go to the header. And this is amazing. You see 9 areas over here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So we have the main row. That is what you will see over here. And then we can style everything individually. So I can click over here and I can configure the logo, the content, and the design. The same goes for the menu. I can click on it and I can configure it, the content and the design, and with everything I have over here. So if I would go back, I see a few things I can add over here. So I can add social media icons to the center, for instance, or I can drag the menu to the center. Socials to the right, or I can drag socials to the top row and the search also, bring the menu to the right and have it like that. Well, then I want to change the height of the main row. How can I do that? I can click over here or I can click over here. Then we have the row minimum height. I can change it to 80. Awesome. Then I can go to design and here I can say I want to have a different background. So I can choose a color. Or I can choose a gradient, or I can choose an image. And if I would do that, then I can go to the menu. I can go to design and I say, then I want the font color to be white. So that's how you can change the look and feel. I want to bring it back. So I can click over here. Make it dark again. Then I go to the main row. To design, click over here. I can also add an image. Why not? This guy, why not? Then you can change it over here. But I don't want that. So I can remove it. I go to the color and I want to have a white color over here. Okay. Then I want to go to the top row. Make it even smaller. Let's say 30. Go to design, change the color. To this one, for instance. So let's keep it that for a moment. But what I would rather have the colors of my website. So I want to show you a lot at the same moment. So please bear with me. Oh, I almost hit my glass of water. Spilled it. I want to go back and I want to go back. And I want to go to the colors. The great thing with the Bloxy theme, you can have color palettes that can change the look and feel of the colors in your website. So there are a few colors over here and I can choose every color I want to have. So right now I choose this color with the color eye picker or the color pick eyedropper. So I copy this color, the first one, and I paste it here. Then there's the second color. Copy. Okay. Then I want to have an in-between color. So let's say, and I want to have a dark color for the text in the website, not black, just dark. And I want to have a white color. So I have five main colors over here. If I go back to the menu, top row, I can assign here at design this color to this area. In all the settings, I can do that. And then if I go back to the colors and I change those five colors, I change the look and feel of our whole website. So if I would change this color right now, what you will see at the header, it will change with it. So that's really handy. And if that, in that way, if you make a website for a client and he says, you know, I want to have different colors, you don't have to go through the whole website and change all these colors individually. Now you can just change them here and your whole website look and feel will be different. So back to the top row, I go to socials or search, I drag search to the right, click on socials, go to design and make it white. And when I hover over it, also make it white. So when I hover over it, it looks like that. Then I go to the search area to design, also make it white. When I hover over it, also white. Great. Now I want to take a look at the menu. I think it's a little bit small. First, I can select the menu. We have the main menu with our sub menu, and then we can change the look. If I hover over it, it looks like this. I can also do type 2 or type 3 or type 4. Well, whatever you like. I like to keep it clean, so I choose type 1. And I can have item spacing. I can stretch the menu so it will be totally from here to here, but I prefer not to do that. Then there are drop down options, but before I go to the drop down options, there's also the top level design options. So the font color, I say it should be this color, the dark one. When I hover over it, I want it to be color 1, like that. So we maintain the style of our website. And then here we can change the font. I like to say, use Railway, make it bigger. So here we can do arrow up. Let's say 16. Over here, I like to change it to 500, not too bold, maybe 600. Yeah, that's okay. Okay. Click outside of that area. When we hover over it, okay, I can have margin. Okay, let's go to the drop down. That's not what we want, of course. I don't see it when I hover over it. And those are small things that can make people tick off, especially when you have a web design website where you offer web design services and something like this happens. You don't want that. So over here, I want to go to the solid color, see what happens. Okay, so now the whole background changes. So I like the solid one. Then I go to design and the font color is white, which is okay. And when I hover over the background, I want it to become a dark purple one. But also when I hover over the text, I still want it to be white. So right now it looks like this. That's better. Or if you prefer this color. Okay. Then the first color I want it to be this one. So we maintain the style of our website and I don't like how small the text is. So I click over here. I go to Railway again. Okay. Make it a bit bigger. Maybe also just 16. Scroll down, click on these dots again and then change it to capitals. Okay. You know what? 14 is okay. Awesome. So I think it looks beautiful. As I said before, if we go back, we can add more things, some button account. If you have a web shop, you can add custom HTML, a second menu. What I want to do, I want to make it sticky. So when I scroll, it scrolls with us. First, let me publish it. So I go to headers, I click on global header, and here we can make it sticky. So when I scroll down, this area sticks with us. I like that. We can also make it shrink. So if I go back now, or I go to the main row settings, I can make a sticky state row shrink. So when I scroll down, it becomes a bit smaller. It's an option. I don't want it, but it's an option. But there is more. If we go to the global header, so they're sticky. You can also say I want the top and the main row to be sticky. So this row will also be sticky. Like that. Only the colors change. That's something we can configure later. But I prefer only to have the main row to be sticky with us. But there are a lot of options over here. Then the sticky effect, you can change it, but I like the way it is. And you can also disable it on different devices. But what I am interested in is the transparency. So if I turn this on, there's a transparent header. That's what I really like. So what I want to do now, I want to get rid of the socials. I want to bring search to the right. So I only have one row. And when I scroll, it looks like this. When I'm on top, it looks like that. So what I want to do now, I want to click on the main row, go to design. Okay, and there are three options. The default state. The background is white. So on a different page where there's no transparent background, the background of the header will be white. When I'm in the transparent state, I want it to be fully transparent. I can also say I want to make it dark, like this. But I want it to be fully transparent. When I'm on the sticky state, I scroll down, I want it to be white. I can also say I want it to be pink, but I want it to be white. So there's the normal state. So on a different page where there is no transparent background in the header, then it should be white. When it's transparent like this, then it should be transparent. And when it's sticky, it should be this color. Okay, so far so good. We can have borders. So I can say I want to have a, in the transparent state, I want to have a border of 2 pixels or 5 that is pink. So I can see it on the top. Well, you can also say I want it to be at the bottom, but I don't want this. Here is the bottom. I can have a shadow, but I'm okay with that. Now I want to go to the menu, design, and on a default state, those colors are perfect. On a transparent state, I want this to be white. What you'll see, it will become white. And when I hover over it, I also want it to be white and then maybe a little bit darker. And when it's sticky, I want it to be this color. When I hover over it, when I'm sticky, it needs to be purple. So the more you do this, the easier it becomes to edit this. Maybe it's a little bit overwhelming. I hope I explained it well. So what I don't like now is that you don't see the stack. So what I normally do, what I prefer, let me publish it, go back, go to Elementor, Command-0. What I normally do, I go to the hero, which is this area, then I go to the style, and then at the style you see this background. What I can do, I can go to the background overlay, and I can have a gradient with 2 colors. Those 2 colors, for instance, and then I can increase the opacity. So if I would make these 2 colors dark, I change the angle to 90. Now this is visible. Update. And again, we're going to talk in depth about Elementor. I can say Command E, go to the homepage. When you install Elementor, you have this finder. You can navigate through a lot of places in the website. I go to the customizer again. I like everything except for one thing. And that's this dark logo. When I'm, well, this is white. I scroll down, everything looks perfect. But when I'm here, I want to have a different logo. How can I do that? I click over here. Now, since we have those options, it says transparent state logo. So when we are in transparent state, which is right now, I can change the logo. Ooh. Upload files, select files. So I have a white logo. It needs to be the same size and height as the colored logo or this logo. Well, that is the case. So I can choose this one. Select. And then at the sticky state logo, I want to have the colored logo again. Look at this. Now we have a white logo, a white header. When we scroll down, it becomes this. I think this is perfect. So let me see. I have a logo. I have the text. If I scroll down, check that everything is still visible. Okay. And then there's this area and we can search. Awesome. If I go to search, where do I want to show? What can you search? Products, posts, and pages. I can go to design. If I see this color, I want to change it to this one. So when I click over here, let me see, when I click on the icon, yeah, now this is purple instead of, or pink instead of purple. Awesome. So I'm happy with this. I don't need anything else. And what I see, one thing, this color. So I go to the search area to design. And at the transparent state, it should be white. Default, it should be dark. And now you see it. And also on the sticky state, it should be dark. And when I hover over it, it should be pink. So when I hover over it, you don't see it maybe. Yeah, it's pink. Just like this. So one more thing. There's so much, but one more thing. Let me see, where can I do that? If I would go to the header, I go to headers, global header, I need to scroll down. And here at the transparent functionality, I need to display where it should happen. Because if I go to the website, here it looks okay. But if I go to about, it looks weird. So I can say over here, display conditions at the global header, add. I can remove everything. And I can say include this only on the front page. So I need to search for the front page. So I say this transparent header should only be displayed on the front page. Save. Publish. So if I close this, it is displayed on the front page. Perfect. And if I go to the about page, it is not displayed. So that's what you can do. Okay, then I want to do two more things. Go to the customizer, make it 90%. Okay, what I want to do, I'm happy with how this looks, but how does it look on a mobile? So I click on a mobile icon over here, and then we can also create a lot of different things. So first I want to go to the trigger area. I click over here. I go to design. And at the default state, it is purple. I want to make that this color. And when I hover over it, this one, then on the transparent state, I want it to be white. When I hover over it, purple or yeah, pink. I don't know. I think it's more pink. And on sticky, I think it should be dark when I hover over it like that. Then when I open it, you see this with those colors. Well, that's what we can change over here. But before we do that, let's go back to general and we can change how it looks with an animation. But I rather keep it normal. We can also change it to simple, from simple to outline and to solid. Or we can have a text over here, say menu, then use simple. But I prefer to do it like this. Okay. Then I go to the off canvas menu. And then here we can select the menu. I want to have the same menu. So right now it looks like that. And I want to adjust it. So menu type, I can also make it bordered like that. I prefer default. Then I go to design. The font color is white. I'm okay with that. Let's change this first to Railway. Where are you? Okay, click on the dots so I can see everything. Comment minus. Make it capitals. 500. Okay, when I hover over it, I don't want it to be purple, but pink. So over here, make it pink. Drop down font size. 20 is perfect. And what I also can do, I can go back and I can add more things at the off canvas area. So I can add socials, click on it, go to design, make them white. And when you hover over them, pink. And now when I scroll down, they're over here. So that's nice. And you can add other stuff as well. But I don't want that. I want to keep it clean, but it is a possibility. Great. When I hover over it, yes, it still looks good. Yes, is what I want. I can hide the builder so I can see the real result. Click over here. I want to publish it. Okay, what else I want to do? Over here, I see this icon from WordPress. I want to change it. How can we do that? We scroll down all the way to site identity and we can select a site icon. It needs to be square. Upload files, select files. And then I grab my fave icon over here, which is 380 by 380 pixels. And when I open it and I select it, I skip the cropping. I have this icon over here. So when I have a lot of tabs opened, I can see, hey, here's the website from that awesome website guy, whatever that means. So when I would refresh this, you see this icon? Okay. So I close this and now I'm really happy with the result. When we continue in the tutorial, you will not see this anymore because this is an area I recorded later because I forgot. So when I continue right now, you don't see this, but it will be there when you have just uploaded it. So let's continue. I'm happy with this. We're going to take a look at the footer later because right now we don't have a lot of information to show in the footer. What I want to do now, I want to take a look at Elementor. So we are here at the homepage. I click on edit with Elementor, command 0. Now we're going to work with Elementor. Before we're going to do that, I want to change a few things. I go over here. Then I go to the user preferences. And right now when I hover over here, I see three icons. I want to make it four by adding editing handles. And now there are four, which makes it easier to navigate through the website and do things. Then I like to make use of dark interfaces. So here at the UI theme, I change it to dark. Now everything becomes dark. Then I go back, I go to the site settings and I make sure that the site, the width of the site here at layout is also 1140. So it's the same width as the theme. Otherwise your theme can be wider than the content in the website. So I close it and now we can create a beautiful website with Elementor. So first I want to get rid of the template. So right mouse click, delete. If you don't see this, click over here on the navigator, right mouse click, delete. Delete. So the only thing we have is a transparent menu, which we do not see right now. So how does it work? Well, what you have with Elementor is three parts. The first one is a section. So over here, I can click on the plus. I can have a section and in that section, I can have columns. So for instance, two columns. So what you see now is the blue line that surrounds the section. In that section, I can have columns. Right now I have two. And in those columns, I can have elements. So if I click over here, there are a lot of elements, a heading, a text editor, a button, a video, etc. So I can click over here to select the section and then I can configure the section. So I can say the height, it should have a minimum height of 400 or let's say 600. Then I can go to the style And I can give it a background, for instance. So a dark one, like that. Or I can give it a gradient, like that, or a video in the background, or a slider. So we can style the section, but in that section, we have columns. I can have one column, or two, or I can duplicate it and I have three. And in those columns, I can add elements. So I click over here and I can add a heading. And I can also add a text area. And I can add a button. But what I also can do, as I style the background of the section, I can also style the background. Then I can also go to the style and I can add a different background. And by the way, also, I can also add an image as a background. So this one, for instance, like that. But in this case, I don't like that. What I don't like is that everything is really close to the edge. So what I can do, I can go to advanced. I can increase the margin that creates some space outside of the column. And I can add some padding that will create space within the column, as you see. If I think, hey, I like this, I want to use it again, I can duplicate the column. And here I can remove one. And also in an element, I can change things. So I can change the text, my first heading. I can bring it to the center. I can go to the style. There I can change the color. So I can give this a red color. Then I can go to the text and I can say style, make the text also red or black, bring it to the center. And then also here. So every element has content, style, and advanced, but the content is different. So for button, there's the text for the button. Click here, more info. And if I go to the text, there's different area for the content part. So we can change the content here at the left tab. Then we can change the style, the colors. I can make this uppercase or bold. And then there's advanced. So to take it to the next level, also for every element, we can have a different background. So I can close this. I can go to the background and I can make this blue. It's really ugly. I think my first website in 1998 or 1999 has those colors, blue and a little bit more orange. That was what I love. And right now, I think it's not a good fit. And also here, I can increase the padding. So I know I'm showing you a lot at the same time, but I will show you step by step how you can work with this. So it's a bit overwhelming maybe, but the more you play around with it, the more you watch this video, the more clear it will become. So what I want to do, I want to remove this and I want to start with a hero. What is a hero? It's the first part people will see when they enter your website and you can show who you are, what you offer, and what kind of action people can take. So if I take a look at apple.com, what do they offer? They offer the iPhone 12, an image of the iPhone 12. We can learn more, or if we are already convinced that we want this, we can click on buy. So there are two call of actions. There's an image, a title, a subtitle, a bit more information. So that's a hero, the first part. And when I scroll down, I see there's the second part. So I want to do the same. I click on the plus. I want to have one area. Now in the section settings at layout, I change the height to minimum height. And then I want to go for a vertical height of 100. Okay. Then I go to the style and I can have a background like this. But what I want to do, I click on update. I want to add some colors, just as I did with the Bloxy theme. So if I go to the website, copy this, paste it, I click on customize, then I go to the colors. I want to add those colors also to Elementor. So over here, I click on the three lines, I go to the site settings, and I want to work with global colors. The same principle applies. You can create colors over here and throughout the whole Elementor pages and the whole website, you can select those colors. And when I would change those colors over here, all the colors in the website will change. So the first one, copy, paste it. Then there's the secondary color. I paste it and I also use the accent color as a secondary color. Then there's the in-between color. Copy. And I add a new color for it. Paste it. I can give this a name. In between. And then there's the text color. This one. Copy it. So we can maintain the same style in the whole website. And then one more. Just a white color. When I select something that is white, I want to select this one. Okay. Awesome. Update. Okay, so I go back over here to the navigator. I can call this double click hero so we can maintain the structure in our website. If I select this, I will also select automatically the section. So now what I can do, I can have a color and I can click on the custom area and I can choose a global color. Ooh, and now it's in the style of our website or this one. Or we can choose a gradient and we can use both colors. And we can change the angle. But what we also can do, we can make use of images, free images. And you can get them at pixabay.com. And if you are from New York, you can search for New York and find an image. This one, for instance. You can click on free download in full resolution or full HD. I'm not a robot. And you can download it. Okay, there it goes. I want to rename it. So I click on show in Finder. And I call this one New York. And before that, again, web design New York. That's what I want to be found on. Okay. So I can click over here again. Click on the plus. Upload files, select a file. I go to my downloads, Web Design New York. Then I click on insert media and there it is. Okay, what I can do here below, I can change the position. So I can say center, center, or I can say over here at size cover. So it shows the most possible about this image. So it's up to you. This is kind of nice. Is also. So what else can we do? We can add a video. So if I would go to YouTube and I search for web design promo or agency promo video, right mouse click, copy the link address. And if I take a look at the video, it starts with someone walking. Okay, I want to skip that part. I can paste it over here, the video link, and you'll see it will appear. But what I can do, I can change the walking area. So I can say start the timer at 8 seconds, for instance. And at the end, there's this area. If you don't want that, I'm not saying you should copy other ones' videos and show it on your own screen. I just want to show you what is possible. 38. So it will start from second 8, as you see. Awesome. Well, it still looks a little bit weird. So what I can do, I can go to the background overlay and there I can have a gradient in the colors of our website, primary color and the secondary color. I can change the angle to 90% and I can increase the opacity. So right now you don't see the background, the video, and now you see it completely. So you can play around with it, but keep in mind that it will make your website a little bit slower. So I just want to show you what is possible. So over here, I want to choose the image and then I have the background overlay. I can also change the type to radial, but I prefer linear. I can also change the location so I can make it a line and then I can change the angle. So you can play around with that if you want to. So that's what you can do. I bring this to zero, this one to 100. And I prefer an image where people are. So it's up to you. Okay, what I want to do, I want to go back to the background. Do not use cover, but default. And I can point to the top left. So you see more of the bridge or top. Let me see, left center, center left, bottom left, no. Center left. Well, you can do whatever you want to do. Yeah, that's fine for me. Okay, what you also can do, I prefer that, is go to iStock photo. Here you can pay for images. So I can say people office or a meeting. So those images have higher quality, but they also cost more. So if I would say right mouse click open in incognito, that means that I'm not logged in anymore. I can see how much it will cost. It will cost me €9 to pay for this. But then, well, this is not the right image, but then you have a professional image. It's better than Pixabay, but it's up to you. If I go to my recent bath images, I like this one, for instance. So I can download this one. I think it was $27. I can download this image. Confirm my download. But what I will see, it's quite a big image. I can rename this. It's a 34 megabyte. Well, I want to show you something. First, I will call this one Web Design Agency New York, something like that. And how can we make this smaller? Well, I want to go to the homepage, Command E or Control E, homepage. Then I want to go to the back end, to media. Add new, select the file, and I will upload this huge file, and I want to show you how you can make it smaller. So here it is, 34.5 megabyte, which is a lot. That's because it's a high resolution and full quality. So there it is. I select it, I close this, and they made it smaller already while uploading. I can edit the image. I like to use an aspect ratio of 16:9. So over here, I can say 16:9. And now I can make a selection, and that I cannot make it square. It's just the aspect ratio of 16:9. That's what I prefer. So I can select an area that I like. Maybe this. And then I can crop it. What you'll see, the new dimension. Okay, awesome. I can click on save. Now the dimension is smaller, and I want to do one more thing, edit the image and scale it to 9020 by 1079. If I click on scale, awesome. Then I close it. And now if I go over here, you see it's less than 200 kilobytes, which is a lot smaller. So that's what you can do. And then I can go back to the website, edit it to Elementor. I go to the hero, to the style, change the image to this one, insert. And I think this is worth $27. Why? Because this is the first impression you can give to your viewer. So this should represent my office, like colleagues laughing together with a laptop, some water. I want to show fun and professionality. And I hope I can do it through this image. Then I can go over here and I can add a text. So I go to bring it to the center. What I like to say is, we bring your ideas to life. Why do I say that? People want to focus on their business. Maybe they start a new business, and we want to take all the hard stuff out of their hands. They want to focus on building their business. I want to help them to do the branding, create their website, and do digital marketing so I can promote them and they can get clients and focus on helping clients. So I go to the style. I want to make the color white, or I choose the global color white. And then at typography, I want to change it to uppercase. I can increase the size. We bring your ideas to life. Let me see if this is a real way. I prefer to use real way for all my titles. Yes. And then maybe a little bit less bold. We bring your ideas to life. You want 600. Perfect. Make it a bit bigger. Okay. Update. And then we can click on the I over here and then we can see the result. And the great thing is when I change something over here. So I go to content and I bring this back to the wrong letter V and I click on update. I don't have to refresh this page. It will automatically be refreshed. So that's really nice. I close all this stuff. So here we can edit it and here we can see the results. If you want to see the result right away, you can click on this arrow to the left and you can see how it will look. I want to do one more thing here at the section hero style. I want to go to the attachment and make it fixed. So when I scroll, it stays there. I love that. Update and then it will be like that. So we start to get a really nice first impression for our visitors. And again, take a look at apple.com, different websites. How does their first area look, their hero? Title, subtitle, people can buy or get more information. So we can have two options over here for about learn more. Or if you go to uber.com, get in the driver's seat and get paid, sign up. One option, sign up to drive. So it's up to you what you want, but keep in mind, you need to make an impression. And need to make clear what your website does for the client. We bring your ideas to life. It can be a little bit like, okay, what do you mean? So then you can say learn more or get in touch. And as you see with Apple, there are two options. And with Uber, there's one option, like take the driver's seat, sign up. That's it. We bring your ideas to life. So what I want to do, I want to show my services over here below. How can I do that? Over here, I want to duplicate this area and I say, branding, pipe, web design, pipe, and digital marketing. Perfect. No, it's not. I want to make this smaller. First, less bold. Let's say 400. Make it smaller. I click over here and do arrow down. I want to align it a little bit. Branding, web design, and digital marketing. Nice. And then I want to have a call to action too, actually. So I want to go back, drag a button over here, a button. I don't know if I say it right. I think I say it a little bit British. A button here. And no, I should not even try this. I'm not good at it. My accent is Dutch. I'm proud of it. No, I'm not. I did a course on how to get rid of my Dutch accent. And I need to change my muscles and change the way I talk. And then my Dutch will become weird. So I was like, you know what? It's the way it is. I hope you can appreciate what I teach you with my Dutch accent. So over here, I say learn more. So I want to have my services page linked to that. So I search for services and I select it. So now if people click here, they go to my services page. And on my services page, I can show them, hey, this is what I offer. I have a 3-in-1 solution for you so you can focus on your business. So that's what I can do. Okay. And of course, I want to change the styling. I can have an icon. Angry. But I rather would have a happy face or rather nothing because I don't think it's necessary. And again, if I want to get inspired. No icon. Okay. Or yeah, there is an icon. So I can search for arrow. I need a simpler arrow. Or I say, learn more, do the arrow there, but I don't need that. So learn more, no icon spacing. Then I go to the style and I want to have the background color that is this one. Then I go to typography. I change it to real way. Make it a bit bigger. 18 is perfect. And then uppercase, learn more. When I hover over it, I want to have an animation. So here at style, button, hover. I have an hover animation and I like to make it sync. You know what? When I come to a point in my video that I'm after 40 minutes, I can do weird stuff. You probably will still keep watching so I can do something like this. No. Okay, this is weird. Let's continue with the video. Sorry, I need to make it a little bit fun for myself. So sometimes I do things like this. Okay, that looks nice. I want to bring it to the center. I can do that over here. But what I also can do, I can go to the area over here, the column, and then I can say the horizontal alignment should be in the center. Okay, nothing happens yet. But over here, I want to change something. Right now, you see that this area is covering the whole width. So if I want to duplicate this button, it goes below. So I say Command or Control Z. I want to select the button, go to Advanced, and then go to Positioning. And I want to change the width from default to inline. Oh, now it goes to the center. So now if I duplicate this, it will be next to each other. Okay, that's what I like. Over here, I want to change it to Get in Touch. Not in Toku, but Touch. To the contact page. Nice. And I want to go to Advanced Margin, uncheck this. And at the left, I say increase it with 20 pixels. Okay, what I also can do if I want to, I can go to style, hover, or no, change the color to the second one. And then when I hover over it, this one becomes pink. When I hover over here, style, hover, I make it purple. That is what you can do. We bring your ideas to life. Branding, web design, and digital marketing. Why do I add this? Because we bring your ideas to life. I say something, but actually I say nothing if I don't give it some context. You see web design, so maybe you can guess, okay, maybe it has something to do with a web design. But people need to be sure when they go to my page, when they go to your page, okay, this is what they're talking about. And if I say we bring your ideas to life, learn more or get in touch, or they're like, I don't know what he's talking about, so I will leave this website, or oh, branding, web design, digital marketing. Okay, that's interesting. Sign me up. Let's get in touch. Or I want to learn more about it. So give it some context. That's what I did. And then I can go back to the elements and I want to add a divider over here. Right now it's black and solid. I can change it to a lot of different things. Trees, happy little trees. Align it to the center. I can have some text in between or an icon. And by the way, about all these elements I'm showing you right now, I have tutorials. So if you search on YouTube for Elementor All Elements Explained, look at this. It's 2 years old, but it's still doing a really good job. And also for Elementor Pro, look, this is the thinner version of myself, the thinner version with a weird blonde thing. Some things I make mistakes in life and we learn from mistakes. Well, I don't, because I did like 20 times and every time it went wrong. But then after a few months, I'm happy with it. I want to make a new one, more up to date. I have so many ideas for this YouTube channel, so I'm so excited. So that's why I'm working around Christmas, because I want to make more content. I like it and I want to grow as a YouTube channel. So I bring this back to solid and I can say it should be 100 pixels width wide. Or what I like to do, I like to align it a little bit like that. Okay, then I go to the style, I change the color to white. I can make it a little bit bolder. If I say 2, what happens? Yeah, better. And I can have a gap. I can close the gap, make it wider. So I update it and then I can see the result over here. Well, no, it's not doing it for me. So what I will do, I will make everything a little bit bigger. So I click here, go to style, make it 65. No, make it 60. Then I click over here and I can align it by making it bigger. Yes. This is okay. Or maybe a little bit more. It doesn't have to align perfectly, but if you want to, you can do that. Update. We bring your IDs to life. You know what I will do? I will not make this full width. No, I will go to the hero layout, vertical height. No, I'll go to pixels. So I can say it should be 400 pixels. So let's say 550. And then I click over here. I go to advanced, uncheck this area. And at the bottom, I say decrease it so I can bring it closer to the line, not too close. And then over here, I do the same. Uncheck this time at the top and I go to the minus. So you can change everything pixel perfect. I like that. And what you can do if you want to, it will make your upset slower, but you can give everything an animation. So over here, I can click. Again, I can also click over here on the heading. And here at advanced, close this, motion effects, say entrance animation, fade in from the left. I can make it fade in slow. I can make it fade in after a second. And I can do the same over here. So advanced, motion effects, fade in from the right, slow after 1.5 seconds. And if I update it, I can take a look over here. Like that. And I can do it with everything, but the more you do it, the slower your website becomes. So it's up to you if you want to do that. So I will bring this back to nothing. No. Over here also, no. But what I can do, I can use this area, the divider. And this time the divider brings this to those two things together. So it's not a divider, it's a together bringer. That's my best English. So fade in from the left, slow and after 1 second. So people think, okay, this is it. But then, wow, whoa, those guys know what they're doing because that animation, let's refresh it. And then they want to do business with me. Wow. Yeah. So what I also want to do, I want to do it with the buttons. So over here, so I can bring some attention to it. So motion effects, this one from the left, you're not just normal after 1 second. No, after 1.25 seconds, this one from the right after 1.5 seconds. Very nice. Okay. Learn more or get in touch. If I click over here, I go to the contact page. If I click on the other one, I go to the services page. Perfect. Okay. What I want to do, I want to go to the section or to the hero, to style, close the background, and I want to go to the shape divider. And there I can add some things to give some animation. Well, I don't want to do anything at the top, but at the bottom, I can have clouds, triangles, and I can change the width, change the colors, invert it. And depending on the option, you can edit things. So over here, the width, I can bring it back. And then at the height, I can bring it down. But it gives a nice style to your website. Update. Okay, so that's what will happen. When we scroll, our menu becomes normal, but we cannot see that yet. What I want to do, I want to create a second area over here below. And this time I want to have two columns. So I click on the plus, I want to have two columns. And in one column, I want to have a heading with a text. So I can talk more about my company in a title. And in that one sentence, I want to tell what I do. So let's start. Typing, something like that. And keep in mind, we are not all text writers and designers and entrepreneurs. It's good to outsource things. So if you're, I'm not a logo maker, this is the best I can do. So if I want to have a really good logo that reflects who I am as a company, then I outsource it to someone else who is good in creating a logo. I have a friend, and when I tell him about an idea I have, he goes to his computer and he just designs something. And I'm like, how can you do that? How can you do that? He does it over and over again. It's really great. And I'm more a teacher. So we all have our talents. So don't try to do everything yourself. Of course, when you start out, you can, and this is what I just made up myself. But if I really want to take it to the next level, I can hire someone to take a look at all the text in my website so we can convert better and help more people. I can go to the style, make it a little bit smaller. 20. Yeah. And then I go back and I want to have a text area. And then I can have a text. And I start talking about myself, but actually I should talk about the client. What can I do for the client? Not about how great I am. No, what can I do for you? Please don't mind how this looks, how the text looks, because I think it looks weird, but I just want to write something. Okay. Awesome. Nice text. And then I can say, I can have a button below that says, get in touch. But what I see this text is purple. So what I need to do, I need to update it first. Then I click over here. I go to the site settings. Then I go to the typography. The text color of the body, it should be this one. So not a colored one. Update. Go back. Close this. So I want to have a button. This time I want to have a button over the full width so I can make it justified. Click here. We change that to learn more. And then again, we go to services. And on the service page, again, we need to be clear on what we offer and what we can do for clients. So I go to the style, to the background color. And the color is over here is white. And when I hover over it, it can become this color. Or you can leave it as this. So if you want to bring it back, reset it, click over here. So we only want to have the sync animation. Okay. Learn more to the services page. And I want to add some margin. So I increase it. No, sorry. Sometimes I'm still confused. Padding. No, come on. This is not what I mean. I need to go to the style. There. Sorry. So I can increase it there. So yeah. And what I see is a small border radius. I can see it better when I'm at the page. I see a small radius. I don't want that. So I say zero. Look at this. Gone. Okay. What I also see is there is a different color over here than over here that has to do with the background settings of the website. We can fix that in the customizer. So I click over there. Then I go to colors, scroll down, background color. I choose this white color. As you see, it's now white. Publish it. Close it. So there you go. I click over here, advanced, and I increase the margin to, let's say, 30 or 40. And I still see the dark background because I need to refresh this page. I save it first and then I say Command R or F5 on the PC. And now everything is perfect. This can be a little bit bigger. I can also change the line height here. So far so good. Learn more. I think that can be bigger and maybe more appealing. Learn more how we work. I don't know. As to your text writer, how we work real way. bigger, 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 not too big. Change the transformation to uppercase. Okay, update. Okay, here at the right, I want to have an inner section. What does it mean? I have a section with two columns, and in that column, I want to have inner sections. So I can drag this over here, top left, and then I can have two columns in one column. I can make it three. Now I want to add a few images. So I start with one image. I click over here. I want to upload a few brands I have worked for. Over here, command A, open them all. If we want to optimize them, I can click here, copy the title, paste it in the alt text. Like that. So I want to start over here. WeChat, insert. Okay, what I want to do when I hover over it, I want to make it sync. So how can I do that first? Image size, make it medium. Let's go to the style, hover. So again, hover, sync. Like that. Okay, I don't want to have a link attached. So here at link, I say none. And then I want to duplicate it. I click over here, go to the second image, click here, go to the third image, and I can remove this, duplicate and duplicate, and then I continue. I will fast forward. Then I can duplicate this area, drag it here on top. And then I can say trusted by, bring it to the center. And then you see all those companies update. So we have created two sections already. The question is, how does it look on a different screen? So we can click on this icon, responsive mode. Take a look at the tablet. You see the menu is already optimized, but this is not. So we can make this smaller. If I click over here, I go to the style. And I click on the typography, what I will see is this icon. So for a tablet, I can have a different size than for a desktop. So I think this looks great. And then I go over here to this text, go to the style, and you need to do this only once. So don't think of this like, oh, this is a pain in the butt. You have to do this once and your website will be optimized for all devices. I go to this line and you see the width, but as long as you see this icon, you can change things and give it a different value for all different devices. So far, so good. What I think, if I take a look here at the hero and the height, I can change the height for a tablet. So it doesn't have to be that high. I can make it look like this. Update. So now, if I make this smaller, see, that will look great. But how does it look on a phone? Well, we need to fix that. So again, we can click over here, go to the mobile. Okay, I want to change the minimum height to something like this, or here I can say vertical height. Like that. I can click on the text. Make it smaller, two lines, for instance. Change the line height. Okay. Then we have this area over here. I can duplicate it. What I can do, I can say over here, the first one. I don't want to show this on a smartphone. So I can go to advanced, scroll down to responsive. And I want to hide this on a mobile. Then I go to the second one and I hide it on a desktop. And the tablet. So this one will only be shown on a smartphone. So I can change the content. So what I can do, there's a code over here. This one. You can also search for break HTML break code or line break code. You can also use this one and then it goes to a new line. So also here, I paste it. So we have branding, web design, and digital marketing. And then I go to the style. I want to change the line height like that. Then I go over here to advanced. And for the mobile, I say nothing over here. Nothing. Then I go over here again. And then I go to responsive. Positioning. And then for mobile, I can change it to full width. Also here. Positioning. Full width. And then at content, I bring it to the center. Also here. I can bring it to the center. But then I go to advanced. I want to have a bottom margin of 10. So let me show you the results. This is on a normal screen, on a tablet, and on a smartphone. And if I want to have a break over here, I can do that. Click over here, go to the content, and then again, a break. Remove this. Update. Take a look again. We bring your ideas to life. Branding, web design, digital marketing. Learn more or get in touch. So in that way, we can optimize for all devices. Okay, let's make it a bit bigger again. Tablet mode. You'll see tablet mode when this appears. Scroll down. I think there's not much space over here. So in order to fix that, we can click on the section. Let's go to the tablet mode. Go to advanced. And then here at padding, I can uncheck this. And at the right, I say 30 pixels. And at the left, I say 30 pixels. Update. And voila, more space. And if I want to, I can maybe also do that for the normal screen. Here's okay. I can create some extra padding over here. So advanced, uncheck, bottom. Let's say 15. Right mouse click, copy. Paste the style. Okay. Paste the style and paste the style. Paste the style and paste the style. Update. So it will take some more space. If that is what you want. So that's how you can optimize it for all devices. I bring it back to the normal screen. Let me see. Wait. This looks okay. And this looks okay. And what I can say. Okay. Let me go to the phone. What I can do, I can go to the second area, click over here, advanced, responsive, and I want to hide it on the mobile. And also the third one, advanced. Otherwise, you need to scroll through all these logos, hide on the mobile. So now, when I go to the mobile view, I only see three. So it's less scrolling and people can see WeChat, Volkswagen, and the other one. So that way you can optimize your website for all devices. And that is amazing. And it's easy to do. And what you also can do, and what can look a little bit, it can look a little bit distracting, like, hey, why is this here? But that is because this is shown on the mobile only. So it's a little bit grayed out. And when I would go to the tablet view, it's also grayed out. But when I go to the mobile, you see that this area is grayed out because it's not shown on a mobile. So that's why you see that. So it looks a little bit weird over there, but it's all fine. The viewer sees this and that's perfect. There's only one thing. Now there's also a break over here. So, okay, what I can do, I can duplicate this. Click over here, advanced. Click over here. Get rid of this area. Advanced, responsive. Hide on a tablet and on a mobile. Then the second one, hide it on the desktop. Update. So now you see it perfectly over here. Over here, it looks like that. Over here, it looks like that. So in that way, you can optimize everything. So the sky is the limit. And what I want to show you now is how you can import pre-made areas in your website. So we can do it through a few ways. I can click on the folder here. And as we shown before, we can import pages. There are free pages and pro pages. The pro are better, but we work in the free version over here. Then we can go to blocks. And then we can import pre-made areas like this. If I insert it, look what I can do in a few clicks. I click over here. I go to the style, to the gradient, first color, second color. I turn it to 90. Then I click over here. Let me do this. This is how I would do it in this space. Most frequent asked questions. Click over here. Go to the style. Title should be white. And the text. So I go to the content. Also change it to white. And then that way we can change it to the style of our website. Active color, maybe a little bit grayed out. So I click over here and I can give it a color. You know what? I can, when I'm on the active, it becomes pink. And then you can change the text over here, of course, at the content. So that's how you can make use of blocks. And then again, we can choose something else over here. We can also search for team members. So I click on team. I think, okay, I like this area. And you can have a light one and a dark one. So I go for this one, the light one. I prefer to work with light areas and darker areas. So dark, light, dark, light. And then if I change the style over here, so content, change this to railway and 500 and uppercase, and in a certain color, I can say copy, paste the style, paste the style. And if I think, you know what, at the image, I want it to be bigger or bigger, less border ratios, ratio. Okay. Hover animation sync. I can also copy that and paste it here and paste it here. So in that way, you can build a website quicker with all those pre-made templates and they keep on growing. Or you can make use of pre-made websites by the community pre-made pages. So in my case, I go to ferdycorp.com. Then I go to my website. And then I can go to templates. Those are Elementor templates, elementor.ferdycorp.com. I leave my name and my email address. I say, give me the package. You can download a package with a lot of templates. I need consent because I'm from Europe. Or you can just browse through the website and see something you like. I need to go to my Gmail account. Click over here, get the template pack. And then I can go to all templates. And then I can take a look for Elementor free version and Elementor Pro. I want to go for the complete pages. So I can import something like this or this. And if I want to check it out, I click on quick view. I can see how it will look on different devices. I optimize it for you. And if I want to download it, I can click on download this template. Then I go to my website. I click on this folder, click on the icon, and then I can drag it over here. It can take a while and it will be added to your library. So my goal is to create more templates for you so you can make your website faster. So there it is. I insert it and there it is. So yeah, I can remove this if I want to. I don't need this area. I have it already. I like this area. I can also drag it up just below this area. What you see, it has a negative margin. So how can I fix this? Well, let me clear this. Okay, how can I do this? I go to the hero and I increase the height. Let's say 650. Then I go to the column, advanced. I uncheck this and at the top, I say minus. So I bring it up a little bit. I need to play around with it, especially since we use multiple items over here. So how will this look? The new version. Okay. This can go up. So what I think, I can go back to the hero, make it 550. Then I go to the column, I bring it up more. Just guessing, minus 80. Update it and see the results. Yes, I think this can be a little bit higher, so I go for minus 110. Update, and when it's right, it makes me happy. So, okay, we bring your ideas to life, branding, web design, digital marketing, learn more, get in touch, and then my three services, which are, of course, not photography, film, and web design, but the great thing is we can change the style and the content. So I can click over here and just say branding. Branding. I change the icon. So branding, spray can, bam. Then I go to the style, change this to my primary color, go to the content, change this to the primary color. Maybe, yeah. Or just the text. Then I go to the right mouse click, copy, paste the style, and paste the style. Then I go over here, web design, click over here, scroll up all the way, this one. And the third one is digital marketing, or I say marketing, and I change it to, is there something like, I don't know, maybe something like this, like we know how to do things. I don't know. It's up to you. And then of course we need to change the text over here right now. I will leave it as it is. And I can show images over here. I can change those. I can show a video if I want to. So why not? Go to my Vimeo account. See if I have something nice. My videos. Divi versus Elementor. Grab the link. Copy the link. And play it. Start time. It should have autoplay. And I want to get rid of these buttons. Okay, then I can drag the FAQ. So light area, dark area. More about us, about who I am. I can change the colors really easily. Just like this line. More about us. There can be an icon. Change the color of the button, more about us. Where does it go to? Well, it should go to about. What people say about us, really easy, click over here. Change these colors. And personally, I don't like to work with such a heavy shadow. So I go first to the style. I think I should do that in the column. style, border, box shadow. So, no, that's something else. I think it has to do with the element. Where can I do that? I think advanced border. So I can decrease it a bit and make it less transparent. So then I can decrease it just a bit. And then the lower border, I want to have this line. And then again, right mouse click, copy and paste the style and paste the style. And also here, the text style, okay, it's default. So click over here, go to the style of the typography and make it normal. And if it's too big, well, then it can be a shorter text. And what I also can do, I can remove one of those columns and then it looks better. And I prefer to have those at the same length. So I click over here. Like that. What people say about us, clients we work for. And then if I see there's another title, copy. And then you can paste a style if you want to. And I get rid of this. I don't need it. So that's how you can do that. And the great thing is this is already optimized for all devices. So right now it looks like this.
Hi guys, my name is Ferdy, and in this video,
that is this video. So I better mute it because I was a little bit scared. Like what's happening? I hear myself. Mute. Update. Again. Okay. And I think it's a little bit close to each other. Well, I can just fix that over here by making it 650. Awesome. Let's say 600. So you can still see the titles over here: branding, web design, marketing. Okay, I'm happy. I can align this by making this story a little bit shorter. So that's it. Then we can go to the about page, and then I can go click on the X, complete pages. Let's go to Elementor Pro. And there's an about page. And this is made for Elementor Pro, but let's see how far we can go. Click view. This animation is not possible. But some things are. This is also not possible, but hey, let's see how far we can go using a pro template on a free version. So over here, I can say Command E, about. And I think this is the new way of making websites. So let me close this about, edit the page. I could not see it because I need to activate it with Elementor, which is not the case yet. So I click on edit with Elementor. First, click here, get rid of the title and make this full width, then it will save automatically. And then I can click on the folder, this icon, and I can drag it over here. That's how easy it is. Again, this can take a minute. Oh, that went fast. Close this, about, insert, and let's see what will happen. Because not everything can be done. Okay, so far so good. Okay, this is just standing still, so it still is okay. Nice, our team, and that cannot be seen. And now I wonder if those images are imported. So let me check that, because then we can use them a different way. So let me click over here. Then I go to the back end. Then I go to No thanks. And then I go to media. No, only the images. Okay, fair enough. So I can close this. I can go for an image. I can have an image of someone. And then below that, I can have a heading. I can create it myself, bring it to the center and say, this is Eliza. And she is a photographer in our business. I can make it smaller. I can fix the text. Photographer. Okay. Give this a color. And I can have a few social media icons about her. So you can follow her if you want to. I can change it to the custom colors. I can make them round or a circle. I can make them a bit smaller. And then I can say, you know what, this area. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. I use an intersection. I drag this over here. And then this area. And this below. And I drag this on top again. Okay. And now I can hover, make more people. So I want to show 4 people in this way. So with the free version, you can still do a few nice things. Of course, change the images. You can change everything, of course, and you can click over here, go to style, hover, and make it sync. Copy, paste the style. Maybe create a border around it. And then go to the padding and the margin. Copy the style. Paste the style. Okay. Update, and you can still import pro templates, and here you can say what we stand for, we love each other, etc. And if you want to change this image, click over here, go to the style, and you can change the image to something else. You can even try this. Hey, that's how easy it is. Just drag and drop. Man, and you can change the text. Man, that's how easy it is. So let me continue with that. And if you want to know more about Elementor in itself, like you want to know all the technical stuff, let me clean this up a little bit. I'm there for you. You know, I made a different tutorial. I don't want this to be a 4-hour tutorial. So I just want to show you how to make a website. If you want to dive deep, maybe you want to become a web developer. I have tutorials about Elementor 30, and then I will show you step by step how to work with Elementor. 2 months ago, a lot of likes. And 1.5 hour just about Elementor, how it works. But wait, there is more. Elementor Pro 30. And why do we say 30 after it? Otherwise, you can see videos of my competitors. Reno, what's up? He's a friend of mine. He lives in Rotterdam. I inspired him to make tutorials and now he's doing a great job. And he also had ideas already for himself. I should mention that also. So Elementor Pro, this one is 2 years old, but I have a new one, 2 weeks old. 21,000 views, also a lot of likes, even more than that one from 2 years ago, which is saying that I'm becoming better. And yes, this is a 4-hour tutorial here. I want to show you, man, so much. So advanced custom fields, 1 hour. So I have hours and hours and hours of Elementor Pro videos. You can find them over here. But keep in mind that you always place 30 in the search results. Otherwise, bad things can happen in your search results here. And you'll be disappointed. So I don't want you to be disappointed. So that was that. Our team. Let's go to the services page. But I cannot because I'm in Elementor. So over here, I go to the services page. Let me show you really quick how you can do this. Okay, edit with Elementor. I like to make it a sport to do things as fast as possible. And at the same time, when I teach it to others, I need to be slow. Okay, full width, update. Okay, complete pages, Elementor Pro, services. Yes, awesome. I don't think I use Elementor Pro stuff over here, so I can download this. Go to the website, click over here, go to, no, here. Come on. That's not working. Click over here, drag it, take a sip of water. Web design agency, about. Import, yes, overwrite everything I have, which is nothing. About who we are. Oh, that's the wrong one. Come on. How can I get rid of it? Like that. Like that. Like that. And we are back again. Click on the plus. And web design agency services. Yes. Oh, I could also override it. Okay. So branding, web design, digital marketing. Wow, I have this already. And I have the text. Awesome. And all those links go to the individual pages, which you see over here. So I want to show you a different way because something else we can do. We can click on the eye to see the result. And it's optimized for all devices. And if I go to the contact page, I can also make use of the pre-made templates of Elementor itself. And there are quite a few nice ones. And they're adding more templates. So I click on edit the page. Edit with Elementor. Are guys still having fun? Yay. Can I hear yay? No? Okay. I hope so. Hide. And Elementor full width. It will save it automatically. I click on the folder, but this time I just browse through the pages and I can search for contact. And then I see a lot of pro pages. But there are also free ones. Like this one or this one. That looks nice. Oh, it's a pro one. That's it. I just want to sell you on the pro version. That's why I talk about the pro version all the time. No, I love it that there's a free version and I love that with Bloxy. I love it with Elementor. The only thing you have paid for, if you have it, haven't it already, is a web hosting. But besides that, I want to use a lot of free stuff and I want to use the best stuff. So what I can do, I can click on the hero section, go to the style, change the image to the image I used before. This one. Oh, I did not use before. It's from a different template, but hey, I like it. People are reading your messages when you reach out. Click over here. I think by now you know a little bit what I am gonna do. Remove this. Here you can change the text. I want to make it less bold. Here I change the color. I can change the address to Jan Lijken Street 36 in Maassluis, where I live. And then right mouse click, copy, paste, and paste. Over here, I change the color of the text to primary, right mouse click, copy, paste, paste. Change this to 31. Okay, and here I can place my address again. Make sure you select it right. So map, column, and then Google Maps. There it is. I say Jan Luikenstraat 36 in Maassluis. That's how it's called in Dutch. And people will see, hey, it's close to Rotterdam. So if I zoom in a little bit, so I could focus on making websites or doing branding for people inside of Rotterdam and the area around it. And again, bring it back to the style of our website. Change it. And go over here. I'd like to change the style to this one or make it white and change this color or to the text color. The sky is the limit. And when you hover over it, there's nothing that can be done. Well, there is. That's the logo, but the background. Yes. So that's how we created our contact page. And if you want to add a contact form, that is possible. Let me show you. Click over here. Go to the backend, and now we can talk about plugins. If I click on plugins, it gives you extra functionalities within your website. If I click on add new, I can see a few popular ones or popular over here. And the first one is contact form, Yoast SEO, the classic editor, Akishmet, Elementor, website builder, WooCommerce, Jetpack. And about all these things, I have tutorials about Yoast contact form, but I just want to install contact form over here. If you can't find it, search for contact form, activate it, and then there will appear a new area over here, which is called contact. So if you search without Ferdy, I'm confident on this one. Contact form 7 tutorial, hit enter. Yes, mine will be the first one. This is an amazing tutorial where I show you so much of what you can do with contact form. And so here I will leave that if you want to know more about it. But there's a basic contact form over here, which is your name, email, subject, and message. And you can place it over here. So what I did, I copied this code. So if I go to contact, there's a code over here. I can copy it. And then over here, I can search for a text editor. And I can place it, or I can go to the text. And if I update it, and I can take a look, there's a contact form over here. And of course, we need to style it a little bit. So what I can do, I can click over here, go to advanced to percentage, and I say at the right 20% or everywhere. Zero. Like that, and then maybe 2% of space or 1. And then people can leave an email, and where should it go? Well, let's go back to the backend to contact. Then you can go to contact form 1 and you can go to the second tab, and then it will go to your site admin email. And that is in your case, the email address you see over here at general.ferdycorp@gmail.com. So, and to keep in the style of the website, I can go to the hero, go to the overlay, use a gradient with those same colors every time. I use those colors all the time. Let me show you. Because what we can do now is crazy. Maybe you create a beautiful website for a client and it looks like this. Let's go to the homepage. It looks like that. But then your client says, yeah, but I want to use the different colors. I want to work with blue and dark blue. So you're like, okay, now I need to do all those colors again, but not with Elementor and Bloxy, because right now we can go to Elementor. And then if I go over here to the site settings, I can go to the global colors. And if I change those global colors, look at this. What? And then the secondary color. What? Update. All those colors are changed right now. Look at this in the whole website. That's why I love global colors. So if I go to the whole website now, this is changed. The button color, this over here, this, I go to the About page. This color. The Services page. The Contact page. Everything is changed. And then you can calculate 5 hours to your client. Like, it took me 5 hours to change all the colors and you charge $200 for it. Or no, that's not what we're going to do. Then you need to do the same thing at the customizer. So here at colors, you should also change the colors of these palettes. Only the first one. So I will go to ferdywp.com again. I will edit the page with Elementor. I will go to the site settings over here. Site settings, global colors, and then I will grab this color again, copy, and this color. So Bloxy comes to the rescue. Don't you think that the Bloxy theme and the Elementor page builder are an amazing combination to make beautiful websites? Well, I think that's the case. And while I'm seeing this, I think, well, this screams a little bit too much. So click over here. Go to the style of the title, content, typography of the title. It doesn't have to be that bold. Copy, paste, and paste. Awesome. So far, so good. We have a beautiful website optimized for all devices, working with free tools and free images, except for this one. This one is the one I bought, but it's up to you what you want to do. And then we have the other pages imported with my template library, and then the contact page made with Elementor. And since we are talking about Elementor, let me open it in a new tab. Over here we see a lot of elements we can use. Some are for the free version, some are for the pro version, and then there are some general ones. If you have WooCommerce, you'll see those. And then there's WordPress, which are the widgets. But you can add more elements for free. How can we do that? We can go to the backend, to plugins, add new. And then if we search for Elementor, we see the Elementor website builder, but here are essential add-ons, and it gives you 40 plus stunning free elements, including advanced and something else. Click on more details if you want to. A lot of installations recently updated and compatible with the current version of WordPress. So they're really working on this tool. It's amazing. I click on install now, and then we have more elements that we can use so we can make even better websites for free. Activate it. Let me go back. There's a pro version, but we will work with the free version. If I click on edit with Elementor, I scroll down over here. I can close the basic stuff, pro stuff, general stuff. And then we see essential add-ons. Look at this. Advanced accordion, advanced steps, advanced data table. A lot of things over here. What I personally like is how you can use it in combination with blog posts. So I can show the most recent blog post over here. We don't have blog posts yet. We'll take a look at it in a second. Here, the post grid, a pricing table. Look at this. Maybe it looks a little bit basic, but if you duplicate it twice, it looks quite nice. And you cannot do this with the free version of Elementor, but with essential add-ons, you can use it. So in that way, you can see the overview over here. And add more things. A sticky video. So you can drag it over here. When you scroll down, it will stick with you. A team member. We created that. And now we can create it like this. So real quick. John. Or no, this is Dwight. Team member. Dwight. He's our photographer. You can have a text. Social profiles below. You can bring it to the center, change the colors. Man, this is amazing. And that's what you can do with essential add-ons. So I highly recommend that you use that. And there are more teams working on free elements. They of course do that because they have a pro version, but still when you use all the free versions, you can do more with your website. So I update it. I go back to the contact page. Now I want to take a look at blog posts. So what we can do now, we can create a blog for our website with blog posts and all that stuff, but not everybody wants that in their website. And I don't want this video to be a 5-6 hour long video. So I created a separate tutorial for people that want to create blog posts in their website and a blog page. And if you want to know everything about that, you can click over here, or you can go to the description, or you can go to 30corp.com, hit enter, and then you can find the tutorial over here, how to make a WordPress website. And then you'll see over here how to create a blog into your WordPress website. So I go to our website again, 30wp.com. And meanwhile, I created the blog page with all the blog posts. So if you take a look at SMN Things, so he is, for instance, you see how the blog post is displayed. I will talk about creating paragraphs, making text bold, internal and external linking, adding images, titles, things like these, videos, and much more. And with Blocksy, we can create something like this. Go to the previous post or related post, and here at the right, you can have information about yourself. You can have posts. You can even make them sticky. There is so much possible. And I will talk about that in that tutorial about the blog. And if I go to the homepage and I scroll down a bit, I see the recent blog posts. And I show you in the tutorial how you can create something like this. So now we go to the portfolio. There I am again. And also for this area, if you want to create a portfolio, I have a different tutorial for that. If you want to watch the tutorial, you can click over here, or you can go to 30corp.com. Go to tutorials, how to make a website. And there again, I will show that video. So let's continue with the next area of the tutorial. We're almost there. We're almost there. So I've created a portfolio page, and you can see my portfolio items over here. It can be a film or something with photography or web design. I can filter it like this. If I want to take a look, I click here. I see the title, in this case, a video and related projects. I can go up, and that's how it works. And on the homepage, I also showed an area, my recent portfolio items. I show 6 or 9. I should bring that back to 6 or 3. So I scroll down. I click on the element. I say show 3. Update. So let's take a look at a blog post. I go to the blog page and I click over here. And then at the right, I see some text about me. And here I see some posts, and I think they're beautifully displayed. They're called widgets in the sidebar, but also below in our website, we can have widgets, this area. So I want to focus on that area right now. I can go to the contact page, for instance. I can go to any page. And then I click on the customizer. Command minus to make the website a little bit smaller so I can see it in the desktop version. I scroll down, and what I want to do, I want to go to my website. Edit the website with Elementor. Go to the site settings, to the colors. I want to grab the text color over here. So I copy it. Then I scroll down. I'm there already. And I go to the footer. And now we have the same thing as with the header. So here we have the copyright area. And if we scroll down, we see that area. So I can click on the bottom row. I can change the amount of columns. Right now there's only 1 here in the center of this area. I can change it to 2 or even 6. Can change the vertical spacing. So that's really high. I can do that pixel perfect. So I can also say 20. Like that. Okay, there's alignment, vertical alignment. I can make it fixed or fluid. Fluid means that it's totally from the left to the right. So if I have 2 columns, 1 is aligned to the left, 1 to the right, and I make the screen smaller, it will stay totally at the left and it will not be within this box. I like fixed. And where do I want to show this area? Everywhere. Then I want to go to design, and that's why I needed this color, because I want to have a dark color in my footer. There it is. But now I don't see the text anymore. So now I need to go to the copyright area, go to design, change the font color to white, the hover color to this one when you have a link, and that's also okay. That's all okay. I like it, but it can be a little bit darker. So, and before we continue, let me go to the copyright area, and there you can change the text. Web design, you can have a link over here if you want to change the design. Let me publish it. What I want to do, I want to take a look at a few footers, apple.com. You know, a few years ago, it was amazing to have an Instagram followers area and a Facebook like box. I still think it's okay, but it doesn't look that professional. So what do professionals do? Well, there are some text over here, a lot of links. So you have an overview of where you can navigate to a lot of different places. But I can also take a look at my competitors in a different state. So I can say Web Design Agency Sydney. And I can go to this one, for instance. Okay, looks good. And then I go to my footer. And why do I click on the advertisement? Because then I know people are optimizing things for conversion. So here you see trusted businesses worldwide, by businesses worldwide. Link, our services, our offices, and contact us with all those lines. So you see no like box, no Instagram stuff, serious stuff. So let me take a look at the second one. Wow. Smart. Third one. Okay. Scroll down. Also here, contact information, an address, work for us, a few links. So that's it. So you see over time, things can change in the web design world or the way how we make websites. And sometimes, or a lot of times, the big companies, the forerunners, they do it first and then the rest. So we can do the same. We can click over here on the middle row and we can change the amount of columns we want to have. I like 4. And now there are 4 columns. And in those 4 columns, we can have widgets. But before we do that, click on publish. I want to close it now. And then I want to go to widgets. I hover over here. I go to widgets, command 0. So I can see the website full width 100%. And then there are 4 column areas, or 6 actually. And I can add stuff over here. So in the main sidebar for the blog post, we have about me and posts. The footer column, the first one, I can do the same. I can have some contact information, or I go over here. I want to add an image. I can drag it, or I can click and then select an area where I want to show this. Footer column 1. Yes. I want to add an image, our logo in color, for instance. Web design, edit. I can have a title, but in this case, it's not necessary. Here I say forward slash, so it's a link to the page itself, or to the homepage for the WP. Then below that, I can have a small text about my company. So I search for text, footer column 1, and then I can have a text. So I copy this text just to have something. Okay, it can all be I will paste it over here so it has no style. Okay, like that. Then in the footer column 2, what do I want to have? Yeah, what I like to have is a menu. So what I want to create right now, yeah, it's maybe a little bit a lot what I want to show, but let me show you. I go to the customizer and I want to create a few new pages. So I go to the menu. all the way here, down, create a new menu. I call this legal. I want to apply it to the footer menu. No, I want to apply it nowhere. I add a few items, so I create a new page. I call this privacy policy. And the best thing is that you or check the internet on how to create this or go to a legal advisor that can help you. Terms and conditions. But it's best when you got this covered. Otherwise, you can get in trouble somehow. Disclaimer. Like all the information on this website, you cannot be hold us responsible or accountable for things that you learn over here and things like that. So if you have a website about cooking and you say you need to do this in the oven, you burn your hand to the oven, you cannot say, yes, it's the fault from the website because they did not tell me not to touch the oven when it's really hot. So things like that, disclaimer, we are not responsible for anything about something like that. And maybe the information over here can be wrong. So keep that in mind. Because a lot of information changes over time. Publish. And I want to go back. I refresh this page. Okay. Still there. Okay. Footer column 2. I want to go for a menu. Can we have that? Yes. Navigation menu. Footer column 2. I call this legal. Save it. Okay. The third one. I like to go to posts, drag it over here, and I want to have the posts over here. And the fourth one, I want to have posts, but this time change the source to items, post type, item. And here I can say recent case studies or portfolio. You know what? Just say portfolio and here's just say posts or blog. Title, blog. Blog. Red Bull. Do you know where that's from? Oh, by the way, I need to save things. So let me check if everything is saved. Okay. Well, maybe you expect when you refresh this that there is a beautiful footer, but nothing could be further from the truth. If I click on the customizer, click on customize, we need to assign everything. So we need to go to the footer and we need to assign those areas. Here they are called widget area. They're called custom footer in the widget area, but here they are called widget area. Okay, weird. Widget area, drag it over here. Second one, third one. If you're in a really good mood, you can say, hey, I do 4 at 3 and 3 at 4. Just change the route a little bit. But I'm not in a good mood, so I want to bring it back. Come on. You rebellious theme. Yes. Okay, so far so good. Publish. Let's take a look if you scroll down. Okay, nice. So I also want to make this area darker. Middle row, design. It's a little bit hard. It's a little bit slow with the theme. That's the thing I don't like. I can mention it to them and then they can fix it. Okay, I like it. Our logo, and keep in mind that the website is bigger normally, but right now I have this area. So if I would check it out, just copy the link and paste it. Command 0, scroll down. Looks like this. Divine. Okay, I think there's too much text. Legal. I can put legal also somewhere else. So let me show you what we can do. We can go to the widget area, go back, scroll down all the way, go to widgets. Okay, it's not working. Let's go to widgets, to column one, text. Let's get rid of this area. Save it. Then footer two, we can add the legal menu below this text. Interesting. Then we can publish it over here. Make it smaller again. Refresh the page. Now this area will be gone. So now this is empty. What I can do, I can go to the footer. I can remove this. I can drag this to the left, drag this to the left. And then at the middle row, I can say, make it three columns. Okay. Then we can go to design. Sorry. Let's go to the middle row. Yeah. And design. And then here below the font color, it can be white. The widget font color and the link, it says over here, has this color. But maybe you're like, no, I want it to be white. And then when you hover over it, it should be pink. Well, that's what you can do. And over here, of course, we can make it a little bit thicker, in my opinion. So let me see the font color. Okay, the link color, that's what I need to do. Wait, this is not what I want. I want to go to the this area, make it 500, 600. Also make it bigger. Click on the three dots. Let me see. This is for the titles. I'm sorry. 18. 20. Okay. Then I need to click on those three dots. And let's see what happens. Oh, I see. I see. So it's only for this text. I thought it was only for this area. Okay. Make it less. Just make it regular. Yeah. And I think a little bit smaller. 14. Yeah. So now it's the same size. Okay. So let's close it. Okay. We scroll down. So now we have a web define with a text and a legal, some links, our recent blogs, and our recent portfolio items. We can click over here, go up. So let me go to the backend, go to plugins, add new, and we can search for widgets, because there are a lot of plugins with special functionalities. Site origin, widget bundle, widget options, recent post widget with thumbnails. Well, that's already the case with the Bloxy theme. It has it built in, which I really love. Widget for Google reviews. So if you have Google reviews, you can add them into your widget or show them in the as a widget. WP social feed. So that's what you can do with widgets. And let me go to Bloxy. Let's go to the extensions. What I really like is the cookie consent. So I activate it. You can do more, create affiliate marketing posts. You can activate it. Take a look at trending products, all that stuff. So right now, when I go to the website, when you enter there for the first time, so right mouse click, open in an incognito window. When you open this for the first time without any cookies, it will say, we make use of cookies. And this is in Dutch. That is not what we want. So we can go to the customizer. And since we activated this plugin extension, we can scroll down and then over here, we see the cookie consent extension. So we can change the text. We make use of cookies. And you see the real life example. cookie period forever, or and you can say okay. Ok. And then you can say I accept the privacy policy if you want to. Or showed over here. We make use of cookies or left below. You can go to the design, change things over here. And I'm really happy with that option. It's really simple, but it's in a lot of places in the world mandatory to have something like that. And it's just a simple extension. So that's what you can have. Look at this. We can make use of cookies. Okay. And now you're doing the right thing. So what we have done, we created a beautiful website with this nice header. I've shown you that you can have a top header, a bottom header. You can have more areas. You can search. This is crazy. How to, and you see two pages that you can go to right away in the style of your website. If I scroll down, you see a different logo with this menu, nice submenu, which is really customizable. We created this page. I showed you how to import pre-made areas called blocks in Elementor, how to adjust the colors. We created this ourselves and we imported a pre-made page. And then we created a blog post, we created portfolio items, and we created a footer with this area. And we can go back up to the about page. This is a page we have imported. You can adjust the information. This is what we have made ourselves. Our footer again. The services page. Then we have the portfolio page. We created portfolio items so people can see what we are capable of. We can filter them by category. Then we created blog posts. Really important to be found better to attract more customers. And I showed you how to build this up from scratch. And how to configure it in a way using Blocksy that it looks like this. Or I showed you different ways how to display this. Then we have the beautiful sidebar that can be sticky if you want to. And here's more information on how to share this. Some information about yourself, previous post, related post. And again, we can click over here. And then I showed you how to import the contact page using the Elementor templates. And we adjusted the information and adjusted the colors. And here I showed you how to create a contact form. And I have also an in-depth tutorial about how to create a contact form with contact form 7. So what is next? Well, you can do so much more. You can go to YouTube. You can create a web shop if you want to. So you can search for 30 WooCommerce. I show you how to add products to your website. A lot of likes. I did my best to make this video the best possible. Every year I make this video, as you see, 2 years ago, 7 months ago, and every year I want to make it better, give you the best. I even have a Dutch tutorial over here. And that's what I want to do. I want to help people to get the most out of their website. So now you've created this website. What is next? Maybe you want to add MailChimp. So 30 MailChimp. I say 30 because I want you to find me. Complete MailChimp tutorial. It's a year old, but I will make a new one soon. And also here, every year I make a new tutorial. I see a lot of people are copying exactly the same thing I do and create tutorials themselves. But I try to keep ahead of them, make new tutorials, make better tutorials. So that's also what you can do. I also like ConvertKit. I really need a new tutorial about that. It's on how to get more emails. It's 3 years old, man. Time for a new one. What else? Of course, Rank Math. I think it's better than Yoast SEO. How to optimize your website so you will be found better. And again, a lot of likes, 99%. So why I switched from Yoast to SEO and how you can do that. So if you want to work with Blocksy Pro, you can search for Blocksy Pro. I will make a tutorial about that. So you can do even more to your website. And of course, if you want to go in depth with a Blocksy, you can also watch this tutorial. That's on itself 90 minutes. So if you have a lot of free time, man, you know what you can do. And how to make a website with Elementor Pro. Maybe you want to take it to the next level. Well, that's also something you can do. If you take a look 3 weeks ago, 2 weeks ago, I gained a little bit of weight. It's getting worse. But now I want to do my best to get rid of it. Look. Here I'm a little bit thinner. 3 months ago, what's going on? Come on. It's my old studio. It's a little bit dark. This is my old office. This is not, I don't know. So that's it, ladies and gentlemen. I want to thank you for watching this video until this point, man. I hope you're inspired. I hope you built something beautiful, or maybe you're watching it for the first time and now you're going to build it. Well, if that's the case, good luck. Thank you for watching this tutorial, and I hope you will have an amazing tutorial in the end. If you like this video, please like it. Feel free to subscribe for more upcoming videos. And if you have feedback or you want to say something, you can leave a comment below this video. I do my best to read them. I do even more my best to answer them, but there are quite a lot of comments, so I cannot promise you anything, but yeah, that's what I wanted to say. Have a great day and good luck with your website. Bye-bye.